Welcome to Drinking Bros, presented by GhostBed.com.
Oh, welcome to Drinking Bros. This is one of those episodes where I'm not sure if I'm smart enough to be on. Dan, you may be, but maybe not.
We'll see.
You might be outgunned today.
We'll see, yeah.
We've got a man with four names. I want you to say all four names.
Jan Michael Vincent. Wait, that's only three.
You or me.
Is that
mine?
Carl, Mark, Anthony, Wesson.
Michael, Anthony, Wesson. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
They're trying to fit too many saints in there, I think, yeah. Is probably what it was. Right?
Is that what it was? Your parents super religious?
Like Catholic or something? They tried to put too many saints in there.
Bad half, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. The bad half, you said?
Bad half, yeah.
Oh, yeah. You don't talk to them anymore?
All of it. Yeah.
Oh, boy.
On today's
I like
show,
how we start off on a roll here.
Yeah, on today's show, would you be labeled as a rocket scientist?
It works like on the dating app websites is probably the only thing that it comes like handy with. Yeah.
But yeah, you're a real rocket scientist.
I'm an engineer for SpaceX. Yes.
For SpaceX.
Yeah.
Which is the coolest job in America.
It's good.
And I'm going to give you some shine because I was packing up. We had a long week in LA this week. A lot of guests packing up all of our gear into a rented minivan with my wife out into the street. And there's a guy in a pimped out old school Defender.
You got it.
Who looks like, you look like fucking Timothy Oliphant, tatted up sleeve, cool as shit, dressed to the nines, and you work for SpaceX, and I'm like, I'm this fucking loser
Thank
who
you.
Was
yeah.
a podcast.
I'll take
stuffing
it.
Shit in the back of a minivan, dude.
Oh, wow.
Let's talk about that Defender, first of all. That's an end-all, be-all, like, game changer.
It is. That's my daily driver. But yeah, it's part of a company that we set up. About 3 years ago when I joined the company, we were moving over all my stuff, packed into two boxes, moved it from London to LA, didn't know anybody out here, and I brought my Defender. That was one of the first trucks.
Gesture with your offhand, guy.
Yeah.
Hold the mic with your other hand. That probably will help you out.
Got it.
There you go.
Just
hold it close to your face. There you go.
Got it. Yeah. So, we moved over with a Defender, and that's how it started. So that truck we built up from scratch. It was a European rescue vehicle over in Northern Europe, and it was rolled on its side, and then we rebuilt it, and that's
really?
Why it looks
a
like
a rescue vehicle. Wow,
yeah.
That's the whitest thing I've ever heard in my life. So,
in Europe,
Holocaust.
Yeah.
I told you,
it survived.
We are sponsors to Holocaust jokes. There's the first one.
Oh man, is there any weird shit on that truck?
Yeah,
do you have rocket launchers on there?
It's got nameplates and all kinds of like fleet vehicle Land Rover. Assignments and stuff like that.
Really?
No guns or anything. No.
No hidden compartments for guns and drugs?
No, not
Come
yet.
On, man.
Not
well,
until
you got,
I
that's
sell
the
it
next
to,
step, right?
Sell it to Xander, and then he's going to put some stuff in it.
Xander's working on a Defender right now.
He is.
Yeah. It's one of those cars where you're, in my opinion, the old school Defenders, because I don't like the new ones. I saw the new ones that just came out.
Yeah.
Did you see those?
Yep.
They're kind of a piece of shit to me.
It has its place, but probably not for like the Defender enthusiasts.
It has its place for soccer moms.
Yeah.
Not for dudes who like to have sex with women.
So you're saying it's a new G-Wagon then?
Yes. That's what it feels like to me. I just saw it rolling down the street, and my mom was like, isn't that amazing? And I was like, it is for you.
Yeah.
It is not for just
Well, if your mom says,
dudes.
Isn't that amazing, probably you shouldn't do it.
Exactly.
So right? Not that you shouldn't trust your mom, but mom's speaking from her level of experience.
But I walk out. He's in a tinted one. Mm-hmm. I can't see him. And I'm just eye fucking the shit out of his car. You thought I was probably going to carjack you or something. Like,
we are in Los Angeles, so anything can happen, right? So,
boy, in one block over, there's an encampment of about 800 homeless people with HOAs. And
thing. We got here Sunday. We noticed immediately that there were a lot, because we were here last year. We're here. He lived here for 18 years. I've been down here a bunch. We noticed that there's a lot more fucking homeless people just living on the street like that. And I'm starting to see bigger and bigger encampments. I'm like, hey, somebody needs to set up an HOA for these people.
Yep.
Because I'm seeing yellow tarps. I'm seeing green and blue tarps. No, we're all blue around here.
Yeah.
Get rid of that fucking green tarp bullshit.
So what Dan's going to do is color coordinate it for you. Because you work at SpaceX. You have a nice job. You have a nice car.
Sure.
You have a nice watch.
Sure.
Appreciate that leather. I got the same one as
That's
well.
That's good.
Bango. You need uniform tents in front of your house. You don't need different color homeless tents in front of your house.
Right.
It'll be all one color. Yep. Dan's going to take care of that for
you. I just enforce the HOA regulations, but down at the homeless level.
Yeah.
Essentially, is what it is.
It's below a slumlord. It's a...
I have no actual authority. I'm just showing up high, and they're high, too, and I feel like I can trick them into doing shit. That's all it really is. And we'll see how it goes.
We'll see how it goes. Yeah. What college did you go to?
University of Central Florida.
Really?
Wow, yeah. National champions.
UCF, yeah. You became an engineer for SpaceX?
Yeah, well, you know that. Yeah, I mean, the engineering program is actually pretty good.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah, they're the national champ. They're the national champs in engineering.
When I went,
congrats on the national championship 2 years ago.
Yeah, yeah. It was at 2017.
When I went there, they didn't have a football team. They
at all?
Well, it wasn't worth watching. And no campus set up the way it is now.
That it's campus is dope as fuck.
It's great now.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah, when I was there, it was like half the amount of people. Mm. Yeah, but you know, the degree that is good. It started out as a technical college, and now it's built up. So. Yeah, it was good. So a lot of if you think about Florida and like the overall Cape Canaveral area, mm-hmm. it's like heavily aerospace. So a lot of the guys,
that's a good point, yeah.
just drive out 45 minutes and they have a job at the end of their tenure. Yeah.
Did you get your master's anywhere?
No. No.
So you don't need a master's to work at SpaceX.
No, it depends. They're pretty good. Like they're really hard. They can have their pick out of a lot of like if you think like the name and the brand SpaceX, they can have their choice of a lot of people coming out of college. Mm-hmm. So it's like really difficult to get in. And after that, they're more interested in like the work that you've done, what you can prove, and they just want like badass engineers. Yeah. So if you got a good like history, then you have a good shot at getting in. Yeah.
No shit.
Well, that's what startups do, and fucking that's one of the things Musk has been really good about is continuing to push those startup style business atmospheres mm-hmm. in all of his companies. Mm-hmm. Like these meetings, like if you've read any of the interviews over the years, some of these things, like if you're in a meeting and you feel like you shouldn't be, it's on you to get the fuck up and walk out. Don't waste your time at this company. That's right. one of the things he said in an interview, and I'm like, God damn, dude. If you can take that, like people do that at startups for sure. Then when it gets super corporate or whatever you want to call it, it never continues like that. He's managed to maintain that kind of thing, like what actually Trump is trying to do it for the federal government, where experience and capability is more important than just having a degree, right?
Yeah, it's more value.
Because I can get a degree right now in anything. Like I've got four of them and half of another one. It's just bullshit.
Yeah, right? Mine's in women's studies, and I thought I was good after that.
No, you just like stalk chicks on a college campus. It's not. You don't get a degree for that.
Yep, that's it.
No, you got restraining orders, and it's paper.
Apologize. It was actually not journalism. The same thing. Yep, I didn't get mine in women's studies at all. He's right. I was in journalism.
But he did. Those restraining orders are still framed in your house. So
yeah,
I mean,
something. Yeah,
they're just not signed by the governor.
You keep your feet on the ground and you keep reaching for the stars.
Yeah, and that's
what Casey Kasem always said.
He did say that.
He's dead now. Yeah. So.
Well, we don't know that for sure.
R.I.P. He's frozen somewhere.
He disappeared for like 80 years, and all of a sudden he's dead, quote unquote. No, he's on an island with Tupac right now for sure.
Kids had him frozen.
It's Casey Kasem. Every day they wake up in the morning, they all get fucked up, and he introduces Tupac. He does a show, and that's the end of it. Come on, man.
Welcome to Drinking Bros, by the way. I know you're amped now to be here.
Well, now I know a lot about it. That's great.
What was your interview process like?
Not like this.
I mean, they are very thorough. It's not like a regular engineering interview, but it is technical. Like you have your general screenings with HR, and then it progresses in there. And it's good because they kind of like it. The culture has to fit, mm-hmm. And they can take prime pick of like who they're interviewing. But like a sense of like where I came to fit was that you could actually work with people and get stuff done.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So, you know, there's a place for to have like completely electrical engineers, software engineers, but like for the guys who are like working in manufacturing, like having to go to the floor mm-hmm. and get stuff done and talk to people, you know, that's really important. Otherwise nobody wants to work for you.
Right. Right.
So you have to be like able to like likable, smart, you know, enough and manage projects and get stuff done. Mm-hmm.
Were you one of those kids, though, who was interested in space and astrology and all that stuff?
I was more
astronomy.
Cars.
Astronomy, there it is.
Not astronomy.
There it is. So what happens when we start drinking this late here on this show is it goes from water signs, Pisces, to astronomy, which is the Big Dipper. So we tie it all back around.
Yeah, makes bathroom breaks fun.
Yeah, were you watching The Challenger and all that stuff? Like,
I was living in Florida at the time, so like... You know, that was a big thing for us growing up.
Yeah. It was a big thing for all of us, I think.
Yeah. It was a big thing for all of us. Like, I think that was one of the...
Yeah, you remember where you were that day.
Everybody does. Yeah. Where were you?
Yeah, I was in school.
Same.
Yeah.
I was in school, and they'd wheeled in the TV that had the belt on top of it.
Same, you know? But I had no idea what the fuck was going on. What I didn't know was that space was even a thing until then. I didn't know about NASA. I think it was, like, in fucking third grade, maybe.
Sure.
I don't remember what it was, but, like... I didn't know what the fuck was going on. I just knew that there was some kind of like very somber national tragedy going on.
Right.
That's all I knew.
What about you? What do you remember about it?
I mean, I remember they had the old tube screen TVs, and they had like this big platform for it that they had to roll in.
Yeah.
And had wheels and everything. It was a big thing that they had to plug in the wall and find out where the jacks were and everything. And you're watching it, and everybody goes silent. And you just don't know what to say, right?
Right.
Yeah. You don't know what the outcome is. If it's, this is a test, it's not really real, you know. And then the next course, couple of weeks, then it just sets in. It's terrible. Mm.
But watching that as a kid and then seeing what you've done now, is it almost unbelievable to you that you're like, holy shit. I was sitting in a classroom watching, you know, someone else send people to space, and now I'm part of the team that actually just sent people back to space.
I mean, it's humbling, and you definitely, at the end of the day, you feel good about what you're doing. Mm. You know, I've had jobs before that you get home, there's no like reward at the end. Like, you don't feel like you have a purpose. And yeah, definitely you feel like you've done a lot just for yourself, but like, it's just bigger than that. Right? Yeah. So
it is certainly a noble endeavor. I mean, shit, Carl Sagan's been saying this since the 70s. We can't put all of our eggs in one basket. We have to get off of this planet. And beyond just that principle, all the things that have been developed because of space exploration, like GPS and all, I mean, I'm not going to sit here and list it because it's like a fucking wide array of shit. All the technology that's come out of the concept of space exploration is insane, to be honest. It's like, it's like almost like war. Like, a lot of crazy shit's come out of war that didn't exist before, like cellular telephones, but that's also part of the space program as well. Mm-hmm. Like, without that, none of this shit that we like now exists at all. And let's be real here. We have to diversify ourselves. We don't know if fucking Armageddon's going to happen, and we don't know if Ben Affleck and Bruce Willis are going to be available. Everybody's quarantined right now, and if we need somebody on that rock to blow it up, we may not have it. We got to get on a ship and get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, and I want to send a message to Donald Trump real quick, because I know he watches the show every day.
He does,
if you're sending Affleck up there, put him back on coke and booze. That was my favorite Affleck, and right now he's sober. I don't think he could save the world, but Affleck on coke and booze, he could save nine.
It's called state-dependent memory, right?
Yes.
So if you learn something when you're high or drunk or whatever the fucking case is, you're not going to remember it until you get high and drunk again.
Correct.
So Ben Affleck at his peak, we need him high and fucked up.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Full peak Ben Affleck will save us. Or we can just get Elon to build a spaceship and we'll get out of here.
I know.
One of those two things has to happen.
I know. One thing, though, I would like to make astronauts really cool again. Like, I felt like Buzz Aldrin fucked. You know, like when I saw Buzz Aldrin up on the moon, you know, you always see those shots of him just playboying around. You're like, God damn it. I know he landed, probably got in a spider and then went out to that Hooters in Daytona Beach, you know, right up. He just went up right up the coast of Cape Canaveral to that Daytona Beach Hooters and probably got loose. I look at Bob and Doug.
Yeah.
And I'm like, man, I wish they would have recast him, because it seems like you guys are doing everything for those guys, and they're not really doing dick up there.
Yeah, here's what needs to happen.
It's like an iPhone, doesn't it? Because you guys decked it out.
Yeah, you guys need to get these. You need to fucking treat them like Dan Bilzerian. Like, make your fucking astronaut Instagram influencers. That's what they need to be.
Yes,
on yachts, banging whores, doing drugs all the time, and then they show back up and do their fucking job.
Make astronauts great again. Let's really get these.
Can we have hats?
Guys.
It's MAGA. Yes. It's still MAGA.
It's still MAGA, but you know, we want to make astronauts.
So if you're walking around with a MAGA hat on and somebody slaps it off your head like people are wont to do these days, say, no, I'm talking of the A is for astronaut. Hello? Do you not watch the news?
Back in the day, they were poon hounds, brother. And now I look at Bob and Doug and I'm like, man, that guy was my third grade science teacher. Like, I want to step up my game. You got to get two guys up there. And again, this is just a wish list for Elon. Next time you see him, you know, tell him we said to Musk up, obviously from the drinking
Musk
bros.
Musk up, for sure, yeah.
Right.
But then say, look, man, they had a quick suggestion. We start casting guys who were skip leg day altogether.
Right.
Arms, chest, abs. Real good looking, great hairline like you. No offense, you're a good-looking guy. I don't even want my wife in the room. She's behind me right now. You work for SpaceX. You got a dope-ass Defender. I'm in a rental minivan today. Mm. I don't even want her near your shit. That's the type of dude I want in space right now.
I feel like you can go one of the two guys. Like, for example, Will Smith and Randy Quaid. So you can have one. You can have a Quaid, but you got to have a Will.
Yeah, that's
man,
true.
Come on.
Yeah, where there's a Will, there's a Quaid.
Yeah, there you go. You're welcome.
You guys are terrible.
It's just interesting to listen to this, man. Where there's a Will, there's a Quaid, brother. That should be a t-shirt right there. We get Randy up there. Yeah. He could fuck shit up. Like,
yeah. Can you imagine Randy Quaid as a fucking astronaut? I would fucking pay him any amount of money to see that.
It'd be great.
Yeah.
It'd be great. Do you see? Do you get to see those memos of like, hey, here's who we're casting as the astronauts? Because again, I saw the inside of that ship. It looks like an iPhone screen.
Yeah.
And it appears as if you guys are literally doing everything.
Wait, what do you mean casting as astronauts?
So what I read in the 60s was they looked at the guys and then they decided like who was going to go first, like Lance Armstrong. Right. To me, that was a bullshit pick. Boring. Never did a fucking interview. Mm-hmm. Got home, shook the president's hand, and then lived in Ohio for like 90 years.
But isn't that why Major League Baseball chose Jackie Robinson instead of Josh Gibson?
Correct.
To be their first black player?
Yeah.
Because Josh Gibson was fucking, or Satchel Paige, he was enigmatic, he was wild as fuck, talk shit, but he was way better than Jackie Robinson
right.
was.
You gotta cast
but Jackie
it.
Robinson was a fucking former Army captain.
Yep.
He was a very good looking dude. He was also quiet and he would not say shit.
Correct. Same with Rosa Parks. By the way, they got together and
they didn't cast her. She was just trying to take the bus home, bro.
No, but they decided it was going to be her versus other people. That's what I'm saying with the astronauts.
Well, you've never heard of Medgar Evers, right?
Yeah.
He was one of the chief plaintiffs in the fucking Brown versus the Board of Education, got murdered for his trouble.
He was like 13 or 14 years old, yeah.
He was older. He was a little bit older than that, but no one knew who the fuck he was.
Right.
Still, to this day, if you say his name, people are like, who the fuck is that? Like, Jesus Christ.
But
dude.
In today's world, we got Bob and Doug. Now, all I think of is, welcome to Staples. How many copies do you want? Instead of like, holy shit, are those guys going to Hooters tonight? That's what I want out of the astronaut.
All they have to do is leak a story that Bob or Doug has just a fucking hog on him, though. Like, correct. You know what we found out? TMZ runs a story. You know what we found out? Bob's got a fucking 9-inch hog.
Yeah.
Can you believe this shit?
That.
Yeah.
You're talking about like motorcycles, right?
No.
Oh, no.
Well, I mean, it could be. Depends on how big it is, obviously. Still goes between your legs. But when you guys are going through that, was that part of the process of like, all right, We're going to try to choose cool guys? Or was it just like, all right, here's the two astronauts that want to do it?
There's a selection process with it. But yeah, I mean, I don't know. Yeah, I don't know which one.
I mean, the pool of people that can even do that is so infinitesimal, right?
Yeah.
Like, there's not a whole lot of people that can do that fucking job.
No,
there's a big training regiment that they go through.
I definitely couldn't, which means there's no chance in fucking hell you could do it.
I probably could have. I'm really good at my iPhone.
Yeah.
No. You're the worst at technology.
I've got four apps that I use religiously.
We get calls from like fucking sponsors or people that want to work with us. Like, hey, can you do this? I'm like, look, Ross doesn't understand technology. Assume he's an 85-year-old man from, I don't know, Antarctica that's never seen a phone before. Because that's what you're going to get out of us.
You know what? Hey, do you know what SpaceX did? They made the dashboard usable for an 85-year-old man to just press four buttons, and that's congratulations. That's who's up there right now. Were you part of that thing where they sent the car into space with a fake dummy in it?
It was launched from Cape Canaveral, but it was built like between Hawthorne and the Cape. But I mean, no. I mean, I was building the assembly stuff for Dragon capsule at the time. Mm-hmm. So like, there was a separate. It was all quite hush hush. And who was pulled in on that and what they did with the Tesla.
Oh, really? Yeah. You know, my wife thought that it was an actual man in the car.
Oh, he is. You didn't know that? He's still there.
She goes, what about he's coming the man? Back. And I was like, what?
No, it's Val Kilmer. That's where he's been all these years.
Dude, Val's back. He's going to be in Top Gun 2 coming out this Christmas. We have no affiliation with that movie, but we hope to.
We'll see if it happens.
We hope to. Yeah, we'll see.
So what are you working on there now?
I mean, so there's lots of different developments going on with the company. One of the big pushes is like Starship. And then the other side is Starlink.
What is the Starship? Forgive me. I'm not familiar
with
it.
So Falcon 9 is the current rocket that's going up now.
Mm-hmm.
That rocket has been kind of like the flagship development project for the last like 8 to 10 years. Nine engines, two stage. And that's responsible for taking the top capsule up, which used to be Dragon 1. Now it's Dragon 2. Holds people in it.
It still uses solid fuel and all that.
So is there any people
in
that one?
No, it's liquid fuel.
Liquid O2?
Yeah. So it's LOX, liquid oxygen, and RP1, which is a refined grade of kerosene.
I'm curious about this personally. I don't know if our audience gives a shit, but is there any thought in your organization right now to defeating, trying to get away from the need to escape gravity to launch stuff? Like, there's been so many different propositions over the years, like the space elevator, the cable that goes straight up and all that bullshit, or just having like a fucking closer orbiting space station where you could launch stuff.
You can, right? I think that Elon kind of, well, somebody in the company was working on the elevator, and it wasn't like tangible.
Yeah, it doesn't seem to be. Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it'd be cool. I mean,
but I mean, I want to ask this question because you're a fucking engineer and you can answer it or explain it at least. Explain to people like the amount of energy it takes to escape Earth's gravity, and that like how much weight that adds to your whole
the main thing is the money,
and all that stuff.
Like that most of the rocket is fuel. So yeah. I mean, that's you know, you carry around a couple gas cans. It's heavy. Mm. And as you multiply the amount of fuel, then you need like heavier boosters or rocket engines to like actually get up.
How much fuel are we talking about for one of these 5
balloons? Thousands of gallons.
How many pounds do you think it is?
I don't remember the facts of like stats of like how far it is to get up. But there's so many pounds, thousands of pounds of thrust that you need to get up. So the main thing is you're trying to transport this giant fuel cell up.
Right. Yep.
So as soon as that fuel cell is dead, you want to like drop it.
Jettison and then. So stage two.
That's why it's broken up in stages. Yeah. So some of the rockets were like single stage, second stage, and then a lot of the earlier ones were third. So this is only two stage. But so as soon as that fuel's done, you want to get rid of it because it's just extra mass. So that comes back down, lands, and then you want to take off from that. So if, in theory, you could have another station, then you could like harvest, sit up there,
right,
and then take off again. Yeah. And it would save the amount of fuel that you need.
I mean, it would save... at this point, billions of dollars to have something like that, but who knows if it's even
feasible. Then you have to refuel it.
Yeah. Like the cable is not going to work, probably, right? Like there's no, I haven't seen any kind of evidence. This has been theorized since the 70s. I haven't seen anything that suggests that could actually work. Yeah. And it's basically what I'm talking about is like they bolt a cable that's like the size, like it's like huge.
Yeah.
It's not a cable like this, but it's a huge ass cable that's bolted to the earth, basically.
Like a fuel pump?
Yeah. And this goes up to fucking space with a fuel pump. There's an elevator, whatever the fuck. I mean, that's reductive, but it's essentially an elevator that you can take stuff up with. So you don't have to go, I think you have to get up to 25,000 miles per hour to leave Earth's atmosphere, something like that. And most of the weight and most of the fuel and a lot of the cost comes into that shit.
It sounds so ridiculous to me that they would put a cable into Earth.
It does.
And have that hang there. Because like you guys are just flying these things in backwards now and they're landing on a...
Everything's fueled on the ground, right? Yeah. So yeah.
And then it just lands, so you don't have to rebuy them anymore. Because the last time, I think NASA was doing it, the boosters were just blowing out into the ocean. That was it. They were unusable again.
Yeah, the Falcon 9 was the first rocket that was actually reusable.
Yeah, it was reusable now.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. The rocket itself, yeah.
And because the last one that landed, there was, I think, on a year from L.A., like on Pico, they found like 18 homeless people living in it. And, you know, they were worried that there was going to take over the streets of L.A. with all these old boosters. Of just homeless people living in rocket
and
boosters.
who's
so you guys landed it backwards now and it's landing, you reuse it, which is awesome.
That's true. Yep.
Which is awesome.
Yeah.
When are these guys coming back, by the way? When's Bob and Doug?
The mission, the date's always fluctuating. I mean, they need to be up there for the amount of duration time to complete their work. They're actually working.
Are they really?
What are they
working on? Well, I mean, they're not just having a good view, right? We put them to work, or NASA has them doing work. So,
I haven't seen it.
Yeah,
that's why I asked.
What are they doing?
Yeah, what are they doing up there?
They're working for NASA, so they should be doing experiments, conducting things that we can't do down here. Like they should be good. Like they
looking
can't
for
just neutrinos be having a vacation
shit?
And holiday up there.
This sounds like what you're telling your interns of, like, hey, I'm going on vacation. You guys are gonna be doing stuff while I'm gone, right? Yeah, we're totally gonna be doing stuff while we're gone.
Yeah, how do you know they're actually up there
how
doing
do you know
shit?
They're doing anything? You got cameras on them?
Because they worked their entire fucking life to get there, Ross. They didn't go up there for a vacation.
Damn. Once you're there, they can't stop you, brother.
No, they're probably up there looking for neutrinos or how plants grow in space.
It's like an NBA player who gets a huge contract. Once he's in, he's in. He's like, I've made it. It's a guaranteed contract. I'm good. You're not going to rip out Bob and Dan from space, Bob and Doug, you know? Right?
Nope.
But you don't know what their mission is. Like,
I mean, that's kept hush hush to to NASA. Like some people probably aware of it, but I don't know what's public information, so I don't really want to speculate
Speaking
on it.
Speaking of public information, you know where I'm going with this next, right?
No clue.
Aliens.
Oh no.
Real or fake? What's the answer? What do we got?
I mean, I don't think the company's got like an idea or a statement on like what they feel like aliens are out there. I can ask my like personal opinion.
Yeah.
What I think.
But do you know anything?
I don't know anything. No.
Nothing at all.
Nope.
There is a look in your eye. You looked away. So Dan was in interrogation for a little bit.
Oh, yeah? Like for what? Interrogation for like who was interrogating?
Prisoners?
This guy asked a lot of questions.
Oh, really?
I'm the one who asked the questions. My man.
Sounds like you were in trouble.
No. No, I conducted the investigations. Not.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah. Okay.
Dan worked for you. What would you work for? Homeland Security?
For a little bit, yeah. And yeah, I was in the 82nd Airborne before that.
Yeah. Dan's killed hundreds of people. Mm. So when your eyes shifted like that, Dan taught me that, hey, man, this guy's either a murderer or he knows something about aliens.
It's not an exact science. It just means he doesn't want to answer your question truthfully.
Ah, is that true?
That could mean he doesn't want to speculate, too. And that doesn't necessarily mean he's lying.
Do what's in your heart right now. Say what's in your heart.
I just think that the world's like, and the galaxies are, there's a lot more to it than just us, right?
Oh, so yes.
That's what we believe, by
there's
way.
At least 10,000 fucking planets in the Milky Way that can habitate life.
If you maintain, there's like, is it called like the golden...
The Goldilocks.
Like, zone. There's the golden zone. Hour, which is amazing for Goldilocks taking pictures zone. Of defenders, right? But then there's the Goldilocks
zone
yeah, right? And if you maintain that, you create, and the energy comes off of a life set or like the sun.
Yep.
And as long as you can...
Warm enough for liquid water, essentially, is the test, yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
and as long as you maintain that somewhere out there, then I think you can generate
life. There's 200 billion galaxies in the known universe. The average galaxy has somewhere between 100 and 400 billion stars. Usually there's somewhere between 5 and 10,000 planets that can habitate life. So 10,000, let's say 5,000, conservative, times 200 billion. That's how many planets are out there that would likely have life at some point during their billions of years of existence.
Right.
We're not alone. It's ridiculous to even think
we're not alone. There's aliens. I think you know it, and you're afraid to tell us on the show. That's fine. Do they have two arms?
It's because Elon's actually an alien, and he's like, "Oh, I'm going to get fired and eaten because they eat aliens. Eat us. That's why the government won't admit that they exist because they're like people keep disappearing. They're not probing butts; they're eating people.
Yep. I had a girlfriend in seventh grade just flat out disappear.
I haven't heard aliens. The term like probing butts in a long time. I think that was from like the '80s.
Well, our big. First
yeah.
Our things changed since
our
then?
Very first.
No. Everybody's still probing butts.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that I haven't actually looked at a lot of the newer claims of being abducted by aliens.
What is the latest abduction? Like?
So the latest abduction is marks from like a ballpoint pen. So
there's a lot
of people that claim. So they'll wake up and they've got three marks about the size of the end of a ballpoint pen, and it's on their feet and or arms.
So this comes from a Canadian sci-fi show called Continuum, by the way.
Really?
Yeah. Anybody that traveled through time got three marks on their hand. It's nonsense.
Okay.
I thought they were probing, right? So at least a ballpoint pen's thinner diameter than a probe.
If you're going in rectally, it's not going to leave a mark.
They didn't know how big our butthole was.
Yeah,
you
wouldn't notice that ballpoint pen went in there, right? So
I wouldn't. But I had some great times in college.
Yeah, he's been around the block a little bit.
Yeah. In current day, I would notice, you know. I would say it's probably going to be a little bigger, like a carrot, you know, a medium-sized carrot. Not a baby one.
Like,
not an appetizer one. Like,
why'd you say carrot, though? Do you want it to be fucking super skinny at the end so you get used to
correct.
It a little bit on
and
the way in?
And I tap out when it starts to get thicker. Mm. You know what I'm saying?
And then like, you can use a Sharpie to draw a line around exactly where you tapped out. That's where you need to go.
And then I know on the next rounds, I can push myself and go a little deeper. And that's what Joey Chestnut, the hot dog eating champion, he taught us when he was on the show a couple weeks ago.
Yeah.
You got to push yourself, and then he broke the record.
He had 75 hot dogs
and then
in 3
days
minutes.
Later.
No
he
way.
Broke the record.
What was Kobayashi? He was like
Kobayashi was in the 60s.
63 is the most Kobayashi ever has done. Mm-hmm. Joey Chestnut's done 70 plus 5 different times.
Yeah, so he did 75 on 4th of July.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. He was on our show 3 days before. We host a huge sports show, and there was a gambling bet on it. So we told the entire audience to bet the over 72 and a half. Chestnut came through. Everybody got paid.
Yeah, luckily for us, our fucking our sponsor, who is a gambling site, mybookie.com, didn't drop us after that.
Yeah.
Because we butt-fucked them big time.
Oh.
But it is what everybody knew he was going to break it. Yeah. He was indoors.
Yeah.
The hot dogs were fresher. All the fucking elements were there. It's a fucking, come on, man.
They don't still soak the buns on the contest, do they?
You got to take down that bun.
Yeah. I don't know. I think they should substitute the water with ketchup.
Well, so you have the option to do that.
You get diabetes.
Yes.
You did that.
So you have the option to ask for ketchup or mustard.
Yeah, you can do either.
However, that's going to add weight. You know this from the rocket booster.
Mm. Well, there's no calories in mustard, though. Mustard is zero calories.
But it's like, going to take up some space. It's waste.
Yeah, it's water, like vinegar, celery, and mustard seed.
You know? Guys, I'm no rocket
like celery,
scientist,
yeah.
But I know
calorie,
mustard is waste.
What do they call that? Calorie
calorie reduction?
Caloric intake.
Yeah. Or no, it's calorie negative or something like that. Like it takes more energy to eat and digest celery than there are calories in celery. I don't know what it's called.
Yeah.
That's a fact.
Yeah. I don't know.
That's why I get it when I get my chicken wings.
My grandmother used to chew on it when she lost her teeth. So
on celery.
For you, like in LA, I know that Tesla just opened up a huge factory in Austin. There is rumors that SpaceX is going to be going somewhere else. I've heard Arizona. I've heard possibly Florida. I've heard possibly Texas. Will you be going with it wherever it goes, or are you going to stay here in L.A.?
Well, they've always had a big presence in the Cape, in Florida, mm-hmm. right? So they're still, I mean, the 39A was like the biggest advantage that we got, like when we leased the space from NASA. So they always have, to my opinion, I think that they'll be there for a while. And then they've got another launch site there that they maintain. SpaceX, like the headquarters is down here in Hawthorne where I work. And then there's been speculation on other locations, mm-hmm. but you know, I can't comment on that. I'm not sure what the latest news is on where they're going.
Obviously. I know it's like a huge speculation right now because they're in a kind of in a space race with Bezos.
Yeah.
Bezos is
he's coming into it. Yeah.
What's that thing called?
Blue Origin.
Yes, that's it. Yeah. Terrible name.
I mean, we're not
Amazon
a fan
Prime,
of it.
Like, yeah. His programming, too, they still don't have a show that's over a million viewers.
Right.
Even though the marvelous Mrs. Maisel is winning all the awards. Nobody's watching that goddamn thing. It's the same thing with this Blue Origin. Like, bro, stick to shipping shit to my house, you know? Just keep doing steroids, stay bald, and keep shipping shit to my house. The other shit, leave it to Musk.
Who does steroids? Does he do steroids?
Yeah, dude. He's on
HGH.
Come on.
Really?
Have you seen him?
No.
There is a photo of him that is he's got a fireball behind him.
HGH is like the high-dollar testosterone,
correct.
Right?
Yeah. He's jacked.
Really?
Ripped. Mm. Bezos?
Yeah.
Dude.
I haven't seen him in a while.
Google
you go to
Sam
Jim's?
Bezos?
Yeah, really?
Yeah. There's a reason why there was a girl out there willing to leave her husband for him. For
yeah,
him.
Definitely.
I didn't
wasn't
think
it
was that much of
an attractive guy when I saw
not,
him.
Well, still not. No. He's got that wonky eye, but he's the richest man. Well,
yeah. I thought he could afford it.
Is Musk more?
No,
I don't.
Not Elon's not more, no. But yeah. Carlos Slim is up there. Usually he owns a fucking Latino telecommunications company.
Yeah, but I think
for years he was
the
richest
man.
Right
now,
the real richest man in the world is Vladimir Putin by a wide margin.
Well, nobody knows that because
he's worth about $700 billion.
Yeah, but he's hiding
or so.
Yeah, he's not on the stats when you look it up. Is
no.
he? Yeah.
Fuck no. All that shit's underground. And it's all in potatoes, most of it.
Yeah.
So he's going to cash that in when the time is right.
Yeah, whenever Ireland runs out of potatoes again, he's fucking set.
Can you pronounce Elon Musk as baby?
No.
The baby name?
No.
I think it's a record scratch.
It's a symbol, right? Yeah. It's two symbols?
Yes.
No, it's like five.
Is there
symbols,
an umlaut in there?
I don't know. Yep.
I don't either. I mean,
but you could probably Google it and find out. Yeah, and
when
they probably
when the
pronounce
born,
it. Like,
you guys have a thing?
No, we didn't really know anything about it until it was posted publicly. Mm. Yeah.
There was no cake at the office or anything like that?
No, we don't have cake anymore. The company's too big, so no more cake.
Are you serious? They took the cake away?
Yeah, we have cookies.
But no cake.
No.
Cake goes bad
cookies every day.
Let them eat cake.
Yeah.
No, that's not what that meant.
We do still have sorbet that we can have every day. That's good.
Really?
Yeah.
But no cake.
You got to come down and we'll take a look. It's good.
I'd love to. How's that facility?
It's still good. I mean, when you walk in, it's everything's clean, very well organized. I mean, the best of the best technicians can own and manage the floor. Mm. Like white Snap-on toolboxes and... You know, the 5S, 6 Sigma, all the way through. It's beautiful. Set up initially for, like, the automotive industry.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of the people from the big companies came over and designed it as, like, a production layout. So it works.
I'm surprised you don't have that X, that Tesla X.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I thought it was mandatory for, like, all the employees of, like, hey, let's support the company.
They don't give us a big enough discount on that. So I'd rather drive it to
Falls in your court, Elon.
Not a lot.
Yeah.
Bigger discount,
Elon,
brother.
Come on, brother.
On.
Give a discount out, dude. You got people sending dudes up in space, and now they can't even drive the cars.
No.
You made him buy a Defender, a rescue Defender.
Yeah.
Left on the side of the road in Europe after the Holocaust.
Right. Well, now, I drive every Defender that I sell. So, like, I have a like,
small... Oh, this
small,
is like your side hustle, building
and
selling
Defenders. Yeah, a small
Defenders,
restoration business. It's like, and we build about 6 Defenders a year. It's the only thing that keeps me sane. A lot of engineers like have that work there have like hobbies outside of work.
I'm sure you got to, right?
You have to because you have to have something that takes your stress away from the end of the day. So
your job's intense, man.
Yeah. It's crazy. Yeah. So we sell about 6 Defenders a year to local LA clients. We've just sold one to a guy over in Austin, which is fantastic, and we're building up.
At.
Yeah.
Did you sell Xander's?
It. Yep. Yeah.
Shut
we're building.
Fuck up, Xander.
We're building Xander a truck. Yep.
That's amazing.
It's beautiful. So the
I kind of want to get a
taking pictures of that on Instagram.
I know. I kind of want to get a better one than him so I can flex on him.
Well, next time you're ready, let's build another
get
one.
I'm ready now.
He's going to fight you for it though.
No, I'll stab that bitch.
Yeah.
Xander's easily stabbable. I'll stab him in the lower fucking right or right hand side right down there so there's no major organs or right from stage right.
Yeah, stage right.
His left.
Stage right.
Yeah. He won't bleed out. There'll be no major damage, but he's going to slow him down long enough for me to get that car and get the fuck out.
Yeah. And all I want on the, like, intern, like, the Defender's cool, and I would love that someday, obviously. A restored one, not the new one. My mom would love one, and I love you, Mom, if you're watching. But I would like to put in my headshot for the next spaceman. I think I want to be a spaceman. I can tap a couple buttons and do some stuff.
Where do you want to go? You want to be on the car that's set up?
I just saw.
We can put a Defender up next time. That'd be great.
Yeah, it'd be awesome. And I'll go in it. And when my wife asks, "Where's the man?" It's me.
Yeah, we're gonna take Xander's car when it's all done and we test drive it. We'll just send it back up.
That'd be great. Hey, Xander, fuck you, man! I borrowed your car. Where is it? Boom! On the way to Mars.
See, this is why I can never become that rich, because if I was Elon Musk, I would absolutely do that.
Yes.
I would come to his house and steal one of the Defenders and put it in orbit around Mars and then send him a fucking postcard like with me fucking just like this right here.
Might be hard to land one, though. You probably won't get it back.
No,
you're never getting it back. Fuck no.
It's all right.
I mean, it's a land rover.
He's okay with that, though, right?
Yeah. The rover's landed on Mars, so I think he might.
You could build a Mars rover, land rover.
Yeah.
I don't see why not.
Yeah.
I don't see why not. Speaking of which, I just saw...
What's it got, the third the gravity of Earth?
Yeah.
Should be fine up there.
I saw... some HD shots of the actual surface of Mars today.
Yeah, wasn't it from like the Curiosity rover?
Yes.
Yeah.
And it looked like we actually could build and live there.
Yeah. Have you ever driven up from like LA, like going up to like Big Bear or going up to it's the other skiing city up here that you can go to? But like you stop in between and it's like very desolate. There's not a, like a big population. It looks just like that.
Yes. So why couldn't we live there? What is stopping it on the...
Well, you need to terraform it at some point, right? Like you have to put stuff on there that organically creates oxygen for us to breathe and nitrogen in the atmosphere.
And so here's where I'm going with this. Is this something that you guys are working on?
There's probably a small team within the company that is working on something like that. I think NASA's working on it too. We're working on the vehicle, so we're subcontracted out by NASA to do exploration and go to the ISS, but there is probably somebody with the company, but I don't know who that would be.
Well, I mean, they did it in Total Recall. How hard could it be?
How hard could it be? Obviously, Schwarzenegger would go up, because I know. Look, there's other countries. This is no joke. They were taking applications to go and be the first part of the Mars,
like a one-way trip. Yeah,
a one-way trip, and there was like 6,000 people that signed up. They were like, cool, man. I'll never come back here.
Yeah. But, I mean, you got to think about the psychology behind someone that would agree to something like that. So I'm sure the screening process is going to be wild as fuck.
I guarantee you've dated every single one of them.
Probably, yeah.
Dan's had some crazy...
Really?
Yeah. How about you? You look like a fucking fun, adventurous dude. What's your dating life like? You married?
No, I've been dating a girl for the last 2 years here.
Has she tried to kill you yet or anything?
She's a New Yorker. She's been living in L.A. for about 2 years. She is a City of Hope operations manager, so she works at the cancer hospital.
Ah, shit.
She's a good girl.
And she's tried to murder you yet or not yet?
Lots of times, every Friday.
See? Yeah.
She's Italian, so she's got that blood. Boy.
If you don't get those dinner reservations at Scopa, it's over, dude.
Yeah.
You're not pulling in front of Scopa on Friday night, that Defender, dude.
Yeah, I know.
It's going to be a rough weekend.
You're an Olive Garden guy.
She's a tough girl. She's like just about 5 foot tall.
Mm. Oh, really?
Yeah, blonde, ex-gymnast.
It's dangerous. Yep.
Really? In this country?
Yeah. She's from...
Well, she was. Yeah. She was in Michigan. Yeah, doing... She was I mean, she competed for a while. Yeah.
Really? At University of Michigan?
Yeah.
That's why she lost. I went to Ohio State.
Terrible.
Hey, at least it wasn't Michigan State, right?
Yeah, that's true.
Because you don't want to be a gymnast
there. You don't want to be a gymnast there, right?
No, because that dude's in jail forever.
Is a Larry Nassar joke too soon?
It's bad.
I hope that dude... Terrible, right? Is he dead yet? Has anybody murdered him?
No, he wants to die.
A fucking hope.
Where is he right now?
He's in jail,
but he got like...
That's not going to last long, is it?
Sentences or whatever. And then he came out and pleaded. It was like, jail's too hard. And the judge was like, oh, jail's too hard? Fuck you.
Yeah.
Like, no, you're good, bro.
I think they throw him in Gen Pop and just see what happens.
Same. I agree.
Right? Fuck that guy. He deserves to be dead.
Yeah, I agree.
Say it out loud. Co-sign what we're saying about murder.
Co-sign
We can't. I feel like I'm going to get in trouble after this program. No man.
I feel like if you can wish death on anybody in the world, he's probably safe to wish death upon.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, honestly, there's no worse human being than that guy.
I mean, look, I've got a couple. We had Chick-fil-A delivered earlier today.
Yeah.
And the guy forgot the sauce.
Oh, yeah.
That guy needs to die.
He's done. Yeah. Yeah.
He's on that list of like, hey, man, if he's walking home tonight and he gets hit by a car, too bad. You don't bring 50 nuggets over here with no Chick-fil-A sauce.
The Chick-fil-A sauce is standard. Like, you got to have that.
Have to.
Yep. Polynesian sauce.
That's like walking
sauce.
Into a meeting with no fucking pants on.
No, Floridians, we eat like Polynesian sauce, but like Chick-fil-A sauce big out here. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But you have a jam sauce, or is that like made up?
So.
No, I'm telling you,
he's got
a spicy chicken sandwich with pickles. And then some kind of jam on
the salt and the sweet mix.
Yeah, strawberry or raspberry or whatever fucking flavor you like. Just put it on there and try it and report back.
Dan's been pitching this.
I'm not going to fucking proselytize. I'm just going to tell you that it's good. Go try it and you tell me if it's good. I haven't had a single person say it's not. Not one.
Mm. Yeah.
It's fucking delicious.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
Going to try it.
It's not bad.
The best thing.
I go Popeye's chicken, best spicy chicken sandwich.
Ooh. Popeyes is great.
It's great, isn't
yeah.
it?
It's better
than spicy chicken sandwich.
You guys are fucking super white trash.
Hey, we're not.
Hey, Church's Chicken.
Wait, where from Florida? I'm a doctor. No, where in Florida are you from?
Well, my dad was out in Cocoa Beach, and I lived 7 years out in Satellite.
Mm, I don't know what the fuck that means.
Where's
Satellite Beach?
Near Cape Canaveral.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah. So you saw those going up all the time then?
Yeah, yeah. I grew up in Central Florida, but that was away from all the tourists and stuff, so.
So Trump brought the program back, right?
Yeah, I mean somebody did. They inspired commercial space exploration again.
Mm-hmm. Are you amped about Space Force?
I don't know. I mean, I haven't heard a whole lot of stuff
but
what they're doing lately,
right?
What would be necessary about a Space Force?
Well, today I read this article this morning about China sending up a rocket into space to blow up satellites. Did you read that? Yeah, you read that, right?
I heard that they had a launch. Yeah. Yes,
and they blew up some form of anti-satellite ballistic missile or something to take down other satellites in space. Therefore, we said this a year ago that this wasn't that far behind.
Mm. Were they just trying to clean up all their space trash?
Well, so
maybe
they say,
there's a lot.
That's what they said about COVID. We're trying to clean up all our old people by giving people COVID.
Oh, no.
I'm totally kidding. Totally kidding. It was from a bat at a wet market. Happens never or now. But I feel like we'll never know what goes on in China. If we don't have a space force and we don't have people like Elon Musk and you and SpaceX, they're going to destroy us one day.
I mean, that culture is growing rapidly, right? And
yes.
and all feats, right? So a lot of the products we're getting from them, I mean, you can't compete with that, the pricing on that. So of course we're going to buy into it.
You can't.
Right?
And I'll pull this up real quick, because I'm curious about this as well. I'm surprised that you guys don't get briefed on things like this, because us dumb civilians, us regular people who are just, like me, I'm just carrying my big dumb dick through the streets every day hoping to stay alive, right? But then I read articles like this. Oh, I'm sorry, it was Russia tested an anti-satellite weapon in space, starting in a galactic arms race. And this is, this isn't like the World News Daily.
This didn't really work out for Russia the last time they tried to start an arms race. Their economy collapsed and the fucking wall fell. It just happened like fucking 30 years ago.
So it says the West is enraged and it's raised the threat of a space war by test firing a weapon designed to knock out enemy satellites. That was bound to happen.
And what is an enemy satellite doing, though?
Well, you are the only one who knows these answers, therefore you're on this show. Because you guys are doing Starlink, too, right?
Yeah, Starlink's is big. Yeah, it's coming up. It's coming up.
God, the more and more... Dan, you feel like the more and more we get closer, dude, he starts to get a little squirrelier, dude. I feel like we're on to something. You know about aliens. I'm going to check that off my list. Starlink. You guys are trying to give the world free internet, right? You're trying to free everyone.
Yeah, but it won't be free. We've got to charge for it.
Oh, you are going to charge for it.
I have to, yeah.
Why?
It's a business.
It's Musk, though, baby.
Well,
he gave away all the patents for the electronic cars.
But he still sells cars.
Yeah.
Okay.
He just wanted competition.
If it works, I mean, it will be competitive internet, but it's going to be like the performance is going to be crazy.
Are we talking $39.99 a month, or what are we talking?
That decision is still left up to the big man to what we're going to charge. But from what I understand, it will be competitive when it comes out. Yeah.
How far away are we from... world internet where everybody pays Elon.
So what's public information? I had to look this up before I came on the show with you guys because I know you're going to probe me. But what
probe you? That happens. That happens after the show.
A callback.
You're going to get that ballpoint pen out.
We've actually got a bag of frozen carrots over there.
But the latest is what on the website as of today that Canada and the U.S. will be the first target, like, and that will be for 2020. So have
this
like,
year?
Yeah, this year.
What?
Wow.
The fuck.
And it will
wow,
be
at the end of this year.
Yeah, we'll be high performance internet.
High performance. Yeah. Tell me.
Do you hear that, Spectrum?
Everybody's excited right now. What?
Trash internet.
It's terrible. Trash internet, isn't it? It's really bad.
Well, yeah.
That stat I can't comment on it because I don't know what's going to be like. They're doing beta tests right now, and you can sign up at the end of the month and you can get a unit and
the end
you can
of
test
this
it
month.
Out. Yeah. So you go on Whoa. The go on the website, fill out, you know, you can register and then you'll get like emails and tell you when you can do
it. What's the website?
Just spacexstarlink.com. You could check it out.
That's great.
Georgia, if it's not that, then just Google search it and you can fill it out.
What's your dream speed? He'll be happy with 50 meg up. Is it going to be comparable?
Should be.
Look at that. You sly son of a bitch. You're slick as a wolf. I love it, dude. You're dropping secrets here today.
I mean, it all depends on how everything goes and unfolds. But, I mean, they're beta test now. You can try it. It will be high performance. That's all you can say. But,
on the beta test. We need musknet now, dude. We need the mollusk upon us, dude. I want 50. I want a full 5-0, dude.
Hopefully he's upping his fucking security because there's a lot of fucking major corporations out there that do not want to see this shit happen.
No, not at all.
For sure. This is like trillions of dollars.
This is amazing. I fucking hate Spectrum. There were our office internet. We had Time Warner before. Here's what I'm saying. And we'll go a single on this for our editor back at home, Ibby. Fuck you, Spectrum. Fuck you, Time Warner. I'm going over to Starlink. I'm getting some Musk internet, dude. And that's going to free all of us.
Do you want to hear a super fucked up stat? About 80 to 85% of every city, every location, anywhere in America right now has to choose between one satellite provider and one cable provider, but they don't have options in either one of those categories.
Yeah.
Like they're isolated. For almost 85% of the fucking entire United States, you only have one option when it comes to internet or cable.
Yeah.
Like one serious, if you want to get high speed shit. It's about 83% on average.
I'll take that a step further. All the best shit in my life has been mussed up. Dead serious, man. PayPal? Paid somebody last night in PayPal. Love it, dude. Musted that. Best car I've ever been in? The fucking Tesla. When that rocket went up that you guys sent up into space, I sat in front of the TV like a child watching that thing. Musk did that.
Mm-hmm.
The fuck is Jeff Bezos?
I mean, he also
shipped a package to my house in 48 hours.
Yeah, Musk also.
Congratulations.
Musk also.
I got a child's bed that I got to put together in 72 different pieces. Fuck you, dude. Musk is sending cars to your house now. All you do is swipe your credit card, and the car's showing up in your driveway now.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's amazing. Now he's going to have worldwide internet that's going to compete with everybody for $40 a month.
I don't know. That's a bargain. Might as well get two or three for that.
I'm trying to get this on the record for America now. We want $40 a month.
I mean, that's what's 40, what do you currently pay for your internet?
I think we pay $39.99.
No, you do
for,
not.
For house internet?
Yeah, really? You know, all the fees and everything?
I pay $100 a month.
What is
See?
$79.99?
See, it's about $100, right?
Mine's $104 a month, but it's 950 download speed.
Is there a
950.
You got one gig down.
Great. So what she's saying is it's probably $80. Are we going to be in the $80 range?
I don't know. I mean, we just had a meeting, and that's still to be decided. The man E's have to, like, decide on what...
I'm amped about it. You know
yeah,
what I think
I'm excited about it. And then the end of 2021 is supposed to be global internet.
Thank you very much. Global?
Global. That is
he's
right now...
Wine,
yes, please. Why not?
Are you drinking white claw?
Thanks. Is this the power claw or the regular claw?
I'll give him some vodka now.
He knows about the power claw.
I just want the regular claw.
He's in on
okay,
everything.
That's fine. I'm good. Thank you. Yeah. The more
he's in on everything. For those of you who don't know, a power claw is when you put vodka inside a white claw. It's called a power claw.
Yeah. Which I thought I had enough already, but not for you guys.
Wow.
Not for
I've
Texas.
Had three of those today,
You know more than we know. So, all right, he's got the flamethrower.
Yeah, I have one at the house. Yeah.
Yes. How is that?
Amazing. I've already been through two tanks.
Isn't it legally called not a flamethrower now?
If you look at it, it's probably like a propane, like not a, a thrower, but like a, I don't know. Thrower has to have like maybe 4 feet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
something like this is probably like 2.5.
Like a real flamethrower uses.
It's enough to do damage on the ceiling, so don't use it inside.
Obviously, unless you're joking. You're not going to let your buddy's joint off of that.
I mean, a lot like
well, you could from like 4 feet away.
My house, I did it on my house. Yeah.
Did you really?
Yeah, I wasn't expecting it. It was a big kick when it kicks in. Yeah.
Oh, really? Like
we have popcorn ceiling
recoil.
Well, yeah, a little bit because you get like kind of like this big flame comes out, so you kind of like react and you're still holding it. So it goes up, and you ended up like lighting all the popcorn ceiling on fire.
It sounds like when you piss when you wake up with a boner, kind of, doesn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
So use it outside, but we had one. We got it for they released it to employees, and they had a few extras, and I bought one.
That's great.
So it's great.
How much was it?
Well, they let us have it for a discounted rate, but if you can go buy them on eBay, and they're probably like $1,600 for one.
No shit.
Yeah. It's a deal
after the show. Yeah.
Yeah. Get two.
You never know when that's going to come in handy. There's been 8 situations.
We always need one
this week where I was like, man, if I had a flamethrower,
I would really enjoy throwing flame on that person right now.
Yeah.
Right. I think that's 7-8 times a day.
Yes.
Yeah, and I try not to act on it, but I'd like the ability to.
Yeah. You know, and that's the difference, right? Mm-hmm. You're always 1 second away from just whipping that wheel over to a bicyclist and ending their life because they're going 5 miles an hour.
Do you think it would be actually a concealed weapon? You have to have a permit for it in your car?
I mean, it has to be completely concealed.
Yeah.
Right?
So it's hard to conceal like a flamethrower.
Right.
If you were wearing a pair of Dickies, you probably could.
You might. Like overalls?
Yeah, okay.
You just stuff it down.
Stuff that down, dude. It'd be a weird flex at a Taco Bell if somebody pissed you off and you were like, what'd you say? Oh, fuck you. And then you pulled out that flamethrower through your Dickies. That would be the ultimate flex or the best world star hip hop video of all time.
Yeah, that would be good.
It'd be great.
Yeah.
Do you guys have fun over there? Are you allowed to share memes and videos, or do you guys have like firewalls where you can't access like porn and everything?
There's a lot of firewalls. I mean, they beefed up the security quite a lot. So he's doing the right things, you know. But there's still a lot of fun that goes on. But the guys work hard. They really do work hard there. Yeah. So you have to do stuff that keeps you, you know, motivated to just keep on working. So guys work a lot of hours. And so like he's set up, they have like, I mean, they've got a good chef that designs the whole menu. And if you want, you can have breakfast, lunch, and dinner there. You have like frozen yogurt.
You keep working, right?
Yeah. So it makes sense.
It's we a have Silicon Valley model.
It is.
Childcare, food, all that bullshit.
Childcare, food, dentists.
Nope.
We don't have a haircut. I haven't had a haircut in like 6 weeks because of COVID. So
really?
I'm ready for
that
it.
That whole shit was like done and like, because you look cool.
Oh, thanks. Yeah.
Like you were driving down the PCH and you were like, oh shit, I forgot about that podcast I got to be on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nope. I'm like 4 weeks
cool
over.
Motherfucker.
I'm usually bald.
Really?
No.
Musk was.
Oh, was he?
Yeah.
Oh.
Go look at those early photos. That's what happens when you get rich. You can buy hair.
Unless you're LeBron James. He couldn't buy enough.
No, he could not buy enough. LeBron, that was the only thing that failed him. You know? He's got that huge scar and just couldn't buy the hair at all.
Otherwise, his career's been great.
Go look at early Musk. Look at early Bezos, too.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Bezos is bald, though, right?
Bezos is bald.
But pre-HDH.
But he was pre-HDH. So you're going to see this weird body that you're like.
It's kind of doughy. What? He looked like a thumb with on a hand that had diabetes. That's what he looked like.
How old is Bezos right now?
I would 60. Say 50s. Late 50s.
And he's ripped at 50?
Oh, dude. Jacked.
It's science. Wow. To start, take TRT and HGH or Somorlin, which is a synthetic HGH.
Can you, I'd say what, Giorgio, on your phone, since we're here in LA and we know of our computer, just Google jacked Jeff Bezos and show him the picture with the flame behind him.
Flame.
Oh, because the one.
Is this one the one on his Tinder profile or something? What is this?
When you see this, you
he does not have a Tinder profile, does he?
Look at that. Right there.
No way.
Yes.
What's he trying to light up? Looks like Vin Diesel.
Did he? He didn't do this. Somebody did this, right?
No, he did this.
God damn it, Jeff! You're they've enlarged
his biceps.
Dude.
Look at that.
Before and after of this gimpy motherfucker, dude. He's richer than all of us. He could buy me and rent me out to the Chinese.
Is he single?
No.
Are you trying to bang him? What's the?
I'm just saying, like, what are you doing? You said he was on Tinder, so
no. He was like banging this other chick, and his wife divorced him and took half
his money. Yeah, cheating on his wife. It was the most expensive divorce.
$79 billion, I think it was.
Oof. Yeah.
Something like that.
And then she gave half of it to charity because he never gave to charity. The day after, it was a nice big fuck you. She wrote half the check to charity.
And then she started an OnlyFans account, so to get back at him also.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then Musk, he's with Grimes. She's making weird music. Did you hear about the story of Azalea Banks trapped in his house?
No.
Because it was too big?
It was too big. She couldn't find a way out. She claims the doors were locked, and they were all doing acid, having a threesome.
Well, that happens.
Yeah.
Yeah, you get lost in acid sometimes.
Well, look, I agree with all of it, by the way. Because everybody says up there, all those guys are microdosing. That's the only way to come up with cool shit. Because in all sincerity, right, we're a comedy show, so we're having fun here tonight. You guys are really out there changing the fucking world.
Yeah, it's a lot of stuff going on. Have you ever read the book Stealing Fire?
Nope.
It's about how special operators in the military and people in Silicon Valley have used hallucinogens basically to reach what they call excesses or peak human performance. Mm-hmm. It's a super interesting book. It's the same author as Finding Superman or whatever the fuck that was, Unlocking Human Potential or whatever the fuck.
But it seems like it's more common now. A lot of people in L.A.
It really is.
Everybody's microdosing.
So Sergey Brin and Larry Craig took their fucking CEO in 2000, I think, to Burning Man, the guy that's the CEO of Google now that's been for years. And they're like, hey, we're going to take you to Burning Man for your interview. They took him for 5 days.
For his interview?
For his interview. Yeah. Got him fucking... I mean,
I thought an on-site panel interview was tough.
Yeah, imagine going to Burning Man and having to do drugs with those two
imagine
assholes.
Imagine having to do an eight.
How do you know if you pass?
Desert of Burning Man.
How do you know if he passes? That's a good question.
How do you know if you have a job at the end of it?
I don't know that you do. I don't know that you know if you're a person at the end of that.
Yeah.
Right? Burning Man, you need like 2 weeks off, and you're like, oh, I'm a person. Shit. I forgot about that because I thought I was just hitting the sonic.
I've never been
to
Burning Man. It was probably like a week hangover.
A week hangover?
Yeah.
Like 1 week long, not weak week as long, in not strong. I see what you mean. Yeah.
Not W-E-A-K.
Yeah. It's a week long.
No, no, like a week long. Like last for a while. So, it would take me a while to get back.
Do they encourage you guys to microdose or do anything cool like outside of the box?
No.
That's what we think from the outside. We're like, dude, I bet you they're tripping all day.
No, it's still like it's a drug-free workplace.
Mm. Oh, do they drug test you guys?
I mean, sure, some people do there. Yeah. I'm sure they have something like that, but we're encouraged. And it's drug free.
Because I was worried. I wondered. I don't care if you guys are doing weed, but like weed, because it's legal in California now. Are you guys allowed to do that?
I don't think anybody in California tests.
No, because the company's in multiple states, so no.
No shit.
Nope.
I didn't know how that worked. Because one would think it probably enhances your performance, but you know, it's not like you're playing baseball or something.
Yeah.
Nothing, huh?
Nothing.
No shit.
I don't know. I feel like if you smoke too much weed and you were an engineer, you would end up just creating bongs all the time, right? Like new ways to get fucking high.
Imagine sending a bong.
Elon shows up and it's just like diagrams of different bongs. It's like, motherfucker, you're all fired. Get out of here. What the hell have you been doing for the last 6 months? Well, you were out of town.
By the way, if Starlink happens, it'd be awesome if the password was the baby name.
Oh, no.
You know, like everybody had to try to figure that out to type that in.
You try to remember it first.
Yeah. Good luck with
that. I have bad times with passwords already.
Yeah, so do I.
Yeah.
Well, so luckily, everyone that works for the federal government has a fucking post-it with all their passwords on it underneath their keyboard. Sorry, federal government.
Is that true?
Yes. They're idiots. Because when you work with anything that requires 20 goddamn passwords, no human being can remember that. It's just like the business principle of span of control. I can only manage 3 to 5 people.
Yeah.
You give me more than that, they're not going to get managed. You give me more passwords than 3, then I'm not going to remember them. It's just how the human brain works.
So it's just like 3 to 5 people you can actively manage? Like effectively.
Span of control is what it's called,
Makes sense.
Yep.
Best space movie you've ever seen. Go.
Oof. Armageddon's good.
Mm-hmm. Armageddon's okay. Yeah. I would have thought you would have said like Apollo 13. I thought you would have gone on that
it's
one.
It's too long.
I agree.
Yeah.
I agree. What was the...
Mine's Interstellar, by the way.
Interstellar's
good.
With
McConaughey,
good.
Yeah. Just because
is that
it
what
actually...
Is?
Yeah. Yeah. Because it explains fucking the concept of fourth dimensional, like physical activity and shit like that, and the way we could communicate across dimensions with gravity, which those are real scientific principles, and they built an entire movie around it. That's the kind of shit that gets me nerding out, because I understand that shit, so it makes sense to me.
Right.
You know what I mean? And it was also a great movie, too.
That Sandy Bullock one got me. I didn't see the Brad Pitt one.
What's that? Gravity? Is that what that's called?
Yeah, Gravity got me, dude.
Gravity was good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I didn't see Ad Astra. Did you see the Brad Pitt movie?
I did. It was weird as fuck.
I watched it on the planes. It's hard.
Yeah.
It's only on like a 3-inch screen.
Yeah. First class?
No.
Really?
No, we don't get paid first class. No.
Come on. Are you serious?
I mean, we're still like a startup company, so
a startup that just got valued at $44 billion yesterday, by the way.
Yeah, dude, $44 billion. They don't put you guys in first? if they would have known a rocket, they're a rocket scientist is flying coach.
They're in process.
Ad Astra on a 3-inch screen on an American Airlines flight. People would lose their shit.
They're in the middle of a $1 billion fundraise right now.
Some people do.
At a $44 billion dollar valuation, and this guy can't get first class. Elon, brother. Elon, come
He's
man.
Really good, though. Like, so he's offered up his better means of transportation to make it easy to go to launch sites. It's really good.
I don't like how you didn't just say private jet. Yeah. Is there something that exists that we don't know about
say
that
PJ.
You're referring to right now?
Say PJ.
Because normally, like, oh, he would offer up his private jet. No, he offered up his better means of travel. What has he got? I want to fucking know.
Say PJ.
He's got something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're going to waterboard this dude after we're done today.
Yeah. No, we're not. But it's a private jet. What about the tunnels underneath LA? Have you been down to those?
No.
He took Jay Leno down. Did you see that?
Yeah. Didn't they ride, what was it, an S?
Yes. Or? Yep.
Yeah.
I took it all the way through.
Yeah, look good.
Are you guys working on that?
We have friends that have gone worked on that project within LA.
It's a real KG answer right there. Are you friends with them?
Who? The friends who have gone down there?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, okay, yeah cool. Of course.
What
yeah.
did they say? Like, is that a real plausible thing for the future of Los Angeles and major cities?
I think it has like a lot of challenges coming up to it, but it could work, right? Now they're in Las Vegas, the last that I heard.
Really?
Yeah, we can Google it. We can do it now. We probably have more information than I know.
Hey, you know where I'm going with this, right?
No.
Never do. Area 51.
Oh, no.
That's pretty close to Vegas. Everybody flies into Vegas to get to Area 51.
Yeah, I think
have
it's
you
more
guys been out there?
No, I think it's more internal of Vegas to go like from casino to casino. And if you want to like, you're getting ready, you're all dressed up and you got a show, you're like late and you want to get there in a few minutes, like you can get there quick.
So if I'm trying to see Gaga at MGM, but I want to go to Mastro's.
Look, let's be real. You're going to Thunder from Down Under.
Obviously.
Which one's that?
That's the fucking
Australian dudes that are jacks with the huge penises.
It's Magic Mike's, but they're Australian, basically.
They're probably an HGA, right?
Yeah.
HGH.
All of it's HGH, dude.
Yeah.
That's the future.
Really?
Yeah. I'm
it's like that's the new testosterone. That's the new testosterone.
No, it's an addition to testosterone.
So you got to take them both?
You got to take them both.
You don't have to do anything. This is America. You do what you want.
It is, but if you want to look like Bezos with fire behind you,
he looks good.
When you're 60 years old,
looks great.
He looks great.
Or you can just hire Michael Bay. Either way.
He's living his best life. How about that woman? She's personally responsible for the change of wealth of billions of dollars just by cheating on his wife.
Right, because she left him.
Yeah.
Yeah, so then he had to, I mean, that's what happens when guys break up with girls, right?
I mean, they're still together.
You go out, you hit the gym, you look good.
He's still with.
Yeah. 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 Otherwise, we get fat. We're with the same one for a while, you know.
It's true.
It's just capitalism, man.
We let ourselves go.
You gotta Bezos up, dude, and start shooting up shit.
Yeah.
Now's the point in the show where we get to the drinking bro of the week, which is someone who's inspired you or helps you become the person you are today.
Oh, wow.
Who would you like to give the drinking bro of the week to?
Oh, wow. I mean, anywhere like in the
in
course?
Your whole life.
Yeah. I mean, my father. Okay. Yeah. He was like a big advocate of like me going to school and studying engineering. So if it was up to me, I would have been like in a garage building Defenders all day, which is like my hobby and my passion besides work, you know. But he's the one who encouraged me to. He was an engineer, and I grew up in the garage working on cars with him. He was an English guy. My whole family's English, but he had Triumphs and MGBs. Mm-hmm. But he encouraged me to go through school and you know, you can always go back, right? You can always like do more schooling, and then like if you want to change direction, you can, but you can't go the other way. Like later in life, it's tough. So
it's really tough. Like you got to get your degree done
first. Yeah, your mind's so sharp at like 20, you know, and then afterwards it's harder. So
is he still alive today?
Yeah.
So was he like unbelievably proud of you when SpaceX launched and he knew that you were a part of that?
He's one of the first person I called afterwards. Mm. Like, so it's a big meaningful event when it goes up and you feel like you had a part of it or designed a piece of tooling or something that goes on the vehicle when it goes up. He's the first person I called. Yeah.
Yeah. It's got to be one of those moments in life where you're like, all right, all of this is worth it.
Yeah.
Thank
I mean,
you.
We put a lot of long hours, and sometimes you get stressed out and you don't know if this is like the best use of like your life, but then after that happens, you're great. You feel like a big accomplishment. Yeah.
Yeah. And look, in all sincerity, and I know we joke a lot on this show and
you're
like fuck these guys, but what you guys are doing, you really are changing the world, and it is an honor to have you on the show.
Yeah. Oh, thank you. Yeah.
And I think Elon Musk is unbelievably very impressive. Important.
Yeah, and we're getting $40 internet too.
Like, hey, I'm hey.
So juiced about that.
What do you think bigger?
No, I'm thinking $40 is probably what we're looking at for 50. What is it, 50 megs?
50 meg upload.
Yeah. Yep, 50 meg upload.
I don't know if that's what it is. I'm just, you know, we'll figure it out.
It's all speculation, right? Yeah. But $40 yeah, it would be good. You heard here first. That's what I'm lobbying for, and that's what Ross Patterson does. I like to end the show in the third person, but
sure.
I'm totally kidding. Thanks for being here and taking time out of your day.
Thanks for having me.
I feel like you're way too important for this show. And then afterwards, you probably will say that to us off camera.
Right? Yeah, it's good to be here, guys. Thank you.
Thank you, man. For D'Anthony Holloway, I'm Ross Patterson. This is the Drinking Bros. Good night, everyone.